3,200 pounds, pretty much on the nose. A little Coleman 17BH coming in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. The Coleman name here, it's a licensed name, so it's what's called a private label. This is a small Dutchman Aspen Trail in point of technicality, just with a different decal on the front. That doesn't make it any greater or any less, just simply explaining the what behind what we're looking at. The folks bought this to kind of dip their toes in the pond. They were originally thinking we'd really like a 264BH tandem axle J-Flight by Jayco. And after they had this thing for a very brief period, they made the decision, like, maybe we'll just dip our toes in the pond before we dive in head first. And they went, yeah, we should have just dove in head first and got the bigger one we were thinking of originally. Now, because they're going to a larger trailer, they're swapping up to a newer, heavier duty hitch system. So, ideal for first timers. You're looking at a late model, very low use camper. Basically, you're getting a new RV at a used price tag, and you're even getting hitching included with the price tag. That is an absolutely fantastic series of qualities for a potential first-time buyer. A less common quality about this camper that kind of makes it stick out is the fact that it's a single-axle camper that's a full 8 foot wide, whereas most single-axle RVs are 7 foot wide, and there are a handful of 7.5 wide models out there. So it kind of looks like something like a J-Flight SLX, but it is a little bit wider, which is why you see that side stand next to that front sofa. Now, the extra width does give it some breathing room. It gives it a bigger dinette, but it also means it's a little bit heavier. It's about 10% bigger and it weighs about 10% more, so it sort of makes sense there. Now, what they did here, most of the time when you have a small single-axle bunk model, you'll have the two bunks in the corner, which is exactly what this has. You'll have a side air conditioner unit. Well, sometimes you're on dual roof air, quite often actually, it doesn't matter. But the point I'm getting at is, normally, you have a front corner bed. So what they did here is they utilized a classic gaucho-style bed, which is what it's called when the bottom, like the seat decking, actually slides forward to create a bed. In a sense, if you're looking at RV fossil records, this is kind of the fossilized predecessor version, pre-Murphy bed is what we're looking at here. It's not flashy, it's not fancy, but it gets the job done. And that's the idea behind this. This is a camper, not an RV, not a glamper, if that makes sense to you. Simple, basic, bare essentials. That's what we're looking at here. Like our simple side mount air conditioner. Maybe not as powerful as a roof mount air, but in a tiny box like this, it's going to hold up just fine. You know, the extra overhead cabinet storage here is something some single axles tend to leave out. Fewer now than before. There was a long time where a lot of little campers would leave that out of there, but most major brands have adopted it. I mean, that's some serious storage over there. That big pantry, linen cabinet, whatever you want to call it, right next to the bathroom, between the bath and the kitchen, is fantastic. The single drawer below the stove is great for your utensils, and this is one of these smaller, it's like, what is it, 3.7 cubic foot gas electric fridge freezers. It's not large, but the camper's not large. There's enough cold storage there to get a little family through the weekend. And really, it's kind of what this RV is designed for, is just small family camping over the weekend. If you choose to add a TV, the fact that it does have that gaucho-style sofa, or kind of proto-pre-sort of Murphy bed, if you want to think of it that way, it's directly across from where you could mount the TV. And it actually looks like the previous owners had mounted a TV, so it'll be very easy for you to know where to put that bracket. Now, since the camper is a little bit bigger, they had a neat opportunity to do a bit of a Jack and Jill bunk here, which is not an industry term. It's just one of my weird RV nerdisms. I believe it's number 37, actually. So, a good thing I noticed, windows for the top and bottom bunks. Basic, price-sensitive campers very often will lack one or the other window. Typically, you don't get the top window in a lot of basic entry-level bunks. This is 300-pound rated, by the way. So you got a normal single bunk here, but down below, you have what I like to call a big kid bunk. It's about 50% wider. So if you've got a taller kid, they can sleep corner to corner on that and, you know, be pretty comfortable. They're gonna manage. We do have a dry bath, not a wet bath. That means that the toilet and the shower are separate objects. And you notice it's just a simple, easy entry shower pan, not a step over travel trailer tub. And I believe that's actually their new RV right over there. Essentially, just this little Coleman that they had, but bigger and on steroids. A quick note I want to point out, that is a manual awning. Again, part of the price sensitivity of this brand is that everything is on the simple basic end. Again, that's not a knock against them. It's just simply stating the facts. And I want to point that out because power awnings have become the dominant thing in the industry. It is actually the rule, not the exception. So when I see a manual awning, I always go out of my way to point those out. The front window lets in a lot of extra light and does help the RV look and feel larger, especially with that front gaucho sofa. It's very nice that you can see your way around, you know, you can just kind of peek out at your campsite. And there's some very good things going on here, despite its price sensitivity, like the fact that the windows are tinted, our windows are opening for airflow, it does have galvanized steel wheel wells, so, and a spare tire. All of those are things that entry-level, basic-level campers may often lack. I also just noticed something. Little pockmark up here. I don't know if that is the result of hail, if that's the result of a low-hanging tree branch, but it is purely surface level and cosmetic, kind of one of those things that, you know, like if I bought a used vehicle, I buy it with the understanding that there's going to be at least one bump on something somewhere. And I guess that little pockmark in the metal back there is this camper's one bump. So if you're looking to get started camping or get out of a pop-up after a bad experience with a rainy season, give us a call. We got a handy little one here for you. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.